जनरल साइंस स्टैंडर्ड 6 चैप्टर 5 सब्सटेंसेस इन द सराउंडिंग्स देयर स्टेट्स एंड प्रॉपर्टीज. कैन यू रिकॉल नेम द सॉलिड लिक्विड एंड गैसियस स्टेट्स ऑफ वाटर. चेंज ऑफ स्टेट ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस. लेट्स ट्राई दिस. टेक पीसेस ऑफ वैक्स इन अ बोल एंड हीट देम ऑन अ कैंडल और स्पिरिट लैम्प. How do the pieces of wax change? What was the initial state of wax? What did it get converted into? Now keep the same bowl in cold water. What happens? When a substance changes from one state to another, the process is called change of state of the substance. Coconut oil freezes in winter. Petrol is the liquid which changes into vapor when kept open. Naphthalene balls and camphor are solids which directly change into the gaseous state. What do we learn from this? The state of a substance changes if it is heated or cooled. Every substance in our surroundings is found in either the solid, liquid, or gaseous state. In the past, in the 19th century, the scientist J. Willard Gibbs showed that the characteristic properties of a substance depend on its physical state and the arrangement of particles in it. Solids, example, a piece of iron, has a shape of its own. It retains shape no matter how it is kept. It has a definite volume. Solids like sugar, sand, when poured on a flat surface, form a heap. Liquids, example, water, spirit, oil. It does not have a shape of its own. It takes the shape of the container. It has a specific volume. It occupies definite portion of a container. It spreads on a flat surface on pouring. And it flows downwards along a slope. Gases. Example, air. It does not have a shape of its own. It occupies all the available space. It does not have a definite volume. On changing the pressure on a gas in a closed container, its volume also changes. Heat and change of physical state. You have learned that change in the physical state of a substance is an effect of the amount of heat in it. On gaining heat, the substance changes from solid to liquid and liquid to gas. On the other hand, when the substance cools or loses heat, it changes from gaseous to liquid and liquid to solid state. Can you tell? Does water change into vapor the moment we place the vessel on a stove? No. Does water kept in a fridge change at once into ice? No. A specific amount of heat must be gained or lost before the state of a substance can change. The change in physical state is determined by how hot the substance becomes on gaining heat or how cold on losing it. The temperature and thermometer. When a substance gets heat, it becomes warm and then hot. We put our hand or finger in the water to judge how hot it is. But that is not an accurate measure. Besides, if the substance is very hot, we could get scalded. A thermometer is used to measure temperature. Degrees Celsius is the unit of measuring temperature. There are several types of thermometer available. Nowadays, digital thermometers are frequently used. Let's try this. Take a thermometer from the laboratory. The bulb at its lower end is filled with mercury. The mercury rises to a certain level in the capillary tube above the bulb. You will see a scale next to the mercury column. Reading the figure near the level of the mercury tells us the temperature of air around the bulb of the thermometer. Hold the thermometer in water so that the bulb is completely immersed in the water and read the temperature of the water. Repeat the activity taking some hot water in one vessel and cold water or ice in another. Note the temperatures. Some examples with their temperatures are given in the table. Boiling. Water is continuously evaporating. We know that water spilled on the floor dries up slowly on its own. This evaporation occurs from the surface of the water. What happens when water boils? As the water gets heated, its temperature increases and it evaporates at a faster and faster rate. When water kept on a stove attains a particular temperature or level of heat, then evaporation takes place in all parts of the body of water. Then we see water bubbles rising at a faster and faster rates to the surface and steam mixing in the air. This is called boiling of water or ebullition. At sea level, pure water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. This is the boiling point of water. When water vapor cools, it is converted into water again. This process is called condensation. Condensation of steam also takes place at 100 degrees Celsius. It means that the boiling point and condensation point of water are one and the same, that is 100 degrees Celsius. Freezing. The water kept in a fridge or on ice becomes cooler and cooler, that is, its temperature falls. At a certain temperature, water does not get any cooler but starts freezing and forms ice. The temperature at which this happens is called the freezing point of water. The temperature of a substance can fall below 0 degrees Celsius. Example, the temperature of air in the freezer of a refrigerator is around minus 18 degrees Celsius. It is read as minus 18 degrees Celsius. When ice gets heat, it starts melting or changing into the liquid state again. Ice melts at 0 degrees Celsius. It means that the freezing point and melting point of water are one and the same. each substance has a specific boiling point, which is also its condensation point. Each substance has a specific melting point, which is the same as its freezing point. The temperature at which a substance boils while heating is the same as the temperature at which it condenses when it is cooled. Similarly, the temperature at which a substance freezes while cooling is the same as the temperature at which it melts when it is heated. Various uses of changes in physical state. 1. Candles are made by melting paraffin wax. 2. Solid carbon dioxide, that is dry ice, is used to make ice cream and to keep it frozen. 3. Liquid nitrogen is used in animal husbandry. 4. Sand, that is silica, is melted to make glass. 5. Metals like gold and silver are melted to make ornaments. 6. Iron is melted to make tools. Sublimation. Iodine crystals do not melt on heating, but change directly to the gaseous state. When the fumes of iodine hit the walls of the funnel, they cool to form solid crystals of iodine and stick to the funnel walls. Thus, on heating, iodine does not melt and change to a liquid, but directly changes to the gaseous state. The change of a solid substance directly into a gas or vapor without first changing into liquid is called sublimation. Properties of substances. What will happen if pressure is applied on substances like chalk, brick, alum, glass, or a Rajgira Vadi? These substances break into small pieces or particles. Such substances are said to be brittle. This property of substances is called brittleness. Take an iron nail, try to pierce a cardboard sheet, wet mud, and a piece of wood using the nail. What happens? The nail easily pierces wet mud, but not the piece of wood. It can pierce the cardboard sheet with some effort. Why does this happen? The hardness of a substance is determined by how much resistance it offers to the substances being pushed through it. Stretch a rubber band and let it go, or apply pressure on a piece of sponge and release it. What do you see? The rubber band and the sponge go back to their original shape. Some substances change their shape when a force is applied on them, but return to their original shape and size when the force is removed. This property is called elasticity. Take a flat metal sheet of the size of a notebook. Holding it at an angle, put a drop of water, honey, and gum at different places on the board. Observe how they flow down the slope. liquids flow downwards on a sloping surface. This property is called fluidity. The fluidity of any liquid is determined by how easily it flows. If two blocks of the same size, one wooden and the other of iron, are weighed in a balance, how would they compare? The mass of different substances having the same volume can be different. This difference is because of the difference in their densities. Between substances of the same volume, the ones with greater density are heavier than those of lesser density. Take a glass of water, add some salt, fine sand, and sugar to it, and try to dissolve them. Repeat this, replacing water with kerosene. What do you observe? Some solid substances dissolve in a particular liquid. If a solid does not dissolve in a liquid, it is said to be insoluble in that liquid. Example, salt is soluble in water but insoluble in kerosene. You know of many beverages made by using water and soluble substances. The property of a substance of getting dissolved is called its solubility. When we can look through a substance and see things on the other side, then that substance is said to be transparent. This property of the substance is called transparency. Glass, some types of plastic, clean water, and air are transparent substances. Metals. Substances like copper, gold, iron, aluminium are called metals. Metals are found in the form of minerals deep inside the earth. Minerals from the earth's crust are processed to obtain the metal. In daily life, metals have various important uses. Let us study some common properties of metals. Take a piece of copper or aluminium wire or a small nail. Hammer it repeatedly. What do you observe? On hammering repeatedly, the wire becomes flat. That is, it forms a thin sheet. Metals can be converted into sheets by hammering. This property of metals is called malleability. Hot iron is hammered and made into thin sheets. Visit a blacksmith's shop to observe how this hammering causes it to stretch. Iron bars made to revolve continuously while being hammered become longer. The iron can be drawn into a wire. Metals can be stretched and drawn into wires. This property of metals is called ductility. Metals like silver, gold, copper, platinum can be drawn into fine wires. Drawn means they can be made into fine wires. Electricity flows through metals. All metals are conductors of electricity to a greater or lesser extent. This property is called electrical conductivity. Even when a piece of a metal is heated at one place, the whole of it becomes hot. It shows that metals allow heat to flow through them. This property is called thermal conductivity. Metals have a typical shine or luster. Every metal has a characteristic color by which it can be identified. Pluck the string of a musical instrument like a tanpura or veena, ring a bell or hit a steel box with a metal spoon. Strike a wooden table or a marble floor with a wooden stick. Note the difference in the sounds produced in the two cases. Metals produce a ringing sound. This property is called the sonority of metals. Always remember, during the rainy season or at any other time, do not touch the exposed electric wires or metal parts. Keep all electric lamps or other appliances switched off when not in use. For example, even when the TV is switched off by remote control, do not forget to put off the main switch. It helps to save electricity besides protecting us from any possible danger. Ask your seniors at home to check the electric wiring and fittings in the house periodically. What we have learnt? Solids, liquids, and gases are the three states of substances. The temperature of a substance, how hot or cold it is, can be measured with the help of a thermometer. Heat is the cause of the change of state of substances. Substances have various properties like hardness, elasticity, brittleness, fluidity, density, solubility, and transparency. Metals form a separate group of substances. Metals have some common properties like malleability, ductility, thermal conductivity, electrical conductivity, sonority, luster, and characteristic color.